One of the most beautiful words in the English language is alignment. In human life, the word denotes a sense of connection, agreement, unity, or oneness. In our local cosmic neighborhood, in the inner solar system, sky watchers look forward to the alignment of planets from our perspective on Earth as a special event worthy of observation. On a cosmological scale, however, where celestial objects are thought to have formed under different conditions and are separated by unfathomable distances, alignments, assuming their appearance is not sheer astronomically improbable coincidence, should not occur at all. Such alignments speak to a relationship or communication between these objects, which has no predictive foundation nor explanation in standard astrophysics. And yet, as technological leaps have enabled scientists to gaze deeper and deeper into the cosmos with ever finer detail, such alignments have indeed been observed. In our Milky Way galaxy, a particular group of alignments has puzzled astronomers for more than a decade. In 2011, the astronomer Brian Rees first discovered that a number of bipolar planetary nebulae all appeared to be aligned nearly parallel to the galactic plane. As noted in 2013 in a European Southern Observatory press release, astronomers have used the ESO's New Technology Telescope and the Hubble Space Telescope to explore more than 100 planetary nebulae in the central bulge of our galaxy. They have found that butterfly-shaped members of this cosmic family tend to be mysteriously aligned, a surprising result given their different histories and varied properties. In the press release, Brian Rees stated, "This really is a surprising finding, and if it holds true, a very important one. The alignment we're seeing for these bipolar nebulae indicates something bizarre about star systems within the central bulge." At the time, Rees and his colleagues suggested that mysterious magnetism originating at the galactic bulge may have influenced the nebulae, producing the alignments. The press release stated, quote, "This new finding hints at another more mysterious factor. Along with these complex stellar characteristics are those of our Milky Way. The whole central bulge rotates around the galactic center. This bulge may have a greater influence than previously thought over our entire galaxy via its magnetic fields." Recently, another paper, this one in the Astrophysical Journal Letters, was published on the mysteriously aligned nebulae. And again, scientists are looking to magnetism as the cause of the so-called bizarre alignments. A Science Alert report on the paper states, "The only plausible explanation for the curiously neat alignment of this specific subset of planetary nebulae is magnetic fields, according to the researchers. While the magnetic fields in the galactic bulge aren't currently strong enough to account for the uniform arrangement, they could have been in the past, locking the binaries into alignment long prior to the formation of the planetary nebulae. It is surely frustrating to proponents of the electric universe to hear these interpretations in light of the remarkable scientific data. In an electric universe, the bipolar form of the aligned nebulae is not coincidental. As demonstrated for many decades in the plasma laboratory, the bipolar structure is identical to that seen in the electromagnetic plasma Z-pinch." Physicist Wal Thornhill discussed the role of the Z-pinch in supernovas and planetary nebulae in his 2007 peer-reviewed paper in the IEEE's Transactions on Plasma Science, the world's leading journal on plasma physics. In 2013, Wall discussed in a Space News video how easily the mysteriously aligned nebulae are explained in the electric universe.
"We've all seen those beautiful images of planetary nebulae, the hourglass-shaped objects that have been seen and photographed very successfully through the Hubble Space Telescope and other large new telescopes. The more detail it's seen, of course, the more puzzles have arisen. But the greatest puzzle of all has just arrived in the news that it's been discovered that these hourglass shapes in the central bulge of our galaxy all have, if you like, the stems of the hourglass all facing in the plane of the galaxy. And this is not to be expected if these shapes are caused by the star itself and any objects that happen to be orbiting that star. The surprise for astronomers is that there should be any connection at all between these isolated objects. The other great puzzle is that the expected axis of rotation of stars tends to be in the plane of the cloud of material from which it's formed. This is the standard model of how stars formed and how planetary systems are formed about that star. It's the rotation of the cloud of material that gives it its axis of rotation. But here we're looking at planetary nebulae close into the center of the galaxy and which have their rotation axis perpendicular to the cloud, which is totally at odds with any idea of the formation of the stars from such a cloud. All of this goes to show the inability of astronomers to predict or explain new discoveries in space. The explanations themselves that we see in these reports are in a language that, from the electric universe point of view, is all wrong. Planetary nebulae are supposed to have been formed by dying stars and stars puffing outer layers off in that process. According to the electric universe model, the so-called life and death of stars is a complete fiction. A planetary nebulae is simply a star in which we can see the electrical circuitry of that star. It's being lit by the galaxy. And therefore, you might expect also that the alignment of that electric current towards the center of the galaxy would be along the arms of the spiral. And this would also explain this strange discovery that the planetary nebulae have their axes aligned perpendicular to the plane of the galaxy. This is to be expected in the electric universe model. It's totally unexpected in the old, centuries-old gravitational model of the formation of stars and their planets.
Wall also addressed astronomers' and astrophysicists' reliance on mysterious magnetism to explain the alignments, without consideration of the electric currents that are required to explain the magnetism's presence. As I noted many times on previous videos, while astronomers today have no choice but to acknowledge the pervasiveness of cosmic magnetism, they did not predict it. As recently as the late 1990s, an official NASA webpage on cosmic magnetic fields described standard astronomical theory as follows. On the cosmological scale, there is no data to suggest that magnetic fields are present. They certainly are not important in the dynamics of the universe for any reasonable range of field strengths consistent with present observational constraints. In recent decades, however, radio astronomers have indeed affirmed the existence of cosmic-scale magnetic fields, and their presence is increasingly recognized as anything but unimportant. Other major surprises have followed, including the discovery of galactic magnetic fields of, quote, astonishing order, in defiance of astrophysicists' suggestion that a chaotic process like stellar explosions is the source of said magnetic fields. Like cosmic magnetism, cosmic alignments offer compelling evidence of the organizational influence of electric currents. Consider one of the most profound mysteries I ever discussed on Space News from the Electric Universe: the discovery of so-called black hole radio jets of distant galaxies, all spinning out in the same direction. In 2016, a Royal Astronomical Society press release reported the observation that, quote, supermassive black holes in a region of the distant universe are all spinning out radio jets in the same direction. A lead investigator said of the findings, "This is not obviously expected based on our current understanding of cosmology. It's a bizarre finding." Professor Andrew Russ Taylor stated, "These black holes don't know about each other or have any way of exchanging information or influencing each other directly over such vast scales." On the intergalactic scale, we can find numerous other heretofore unexplained instances of objects having preferred orientations with respect to their surroundings. This includes the alignment of the axes of the brightest galaxies in rich galaxy clusters with the cluster's orientation as a whole. As described in the 2017 Nature Astronomy paper, 10 billion years of brightest cluster galaxy alignments. The most massive galaxies in the universe appear to know about their surroundings. It is well established that the major axes of brightest cluster galaxies are often elongated in the same direction as the galaxy cluster in which they reside, and furthermore, that clusters themselves are aligned with their neighbors, a remarkable coherence of structures over many millions of light years. The authors propose that such alignments are, quote, the product of a special formation history, one influenced by the development of the cosmic web over billions of years. The cosmic web the authors refer to is the vast strands of filaments, both observed and theoretically modeled on supercomputers, connecting vast structures across the intergalactic medium. Like cosmic magnetism, and like improbable or impossible cosmic alignments, cosmic filaments are one of the best clues to the electrical nature of the plasma universe. As Wall was fond of saying, the filamentary structure of electrified plasma, seen in the novelty plasma ball, provides a simple yet meaningful analog to the electrical substrate of the entire cosmos. It is surely significant, not just scientifically, but also philosophically, that our universe is neither empty nor disconnected, a fact that cosmic alignments powerfully confirm. The challenge now for astronomers is to reconsider theories that are misaligned with science discovery, and to begin to align space exploration with the predictive, theoretical foundations of the electric universe and plasma cosmology.